You think this is your time?
What's up, everybody? PG Braun here, president of Blackstone Labs, Prime Nutrition, Celestial Bodies.
And I'm Celeste.
Oh, where's the TT fan club?
I thought you always get irritated when I say
no,
that.
It's
I feel
cute.
Like you think I'm a jerk.
I love TT.
President of TT fan club, and I'm a slacker, and the CEO of Celestial Bodies.
We are in your office, and she wanted to be over here because there's a unicorn on the wall that a lot of people, I'm sure, are familiar with from the fat cream commercial that I did.
It was actually the star. You're a hot babe, but the unicorn was the star of the
movie. We tried to do the unicorn for this one, but the lighting from that angle is atrocious. And I told Celeste that I didn't feel like looking 10 years older and at like least 15 pounds fatter. So we went for the good light this way. That's what you do in showbiz.
Maybe I'll just move the unicorn.
When you're in showbiz or when you have a guy named Eric following around the camera, you look for the best light. So let's just get right into it. This was an awesome week, and I think you guys are going to think this is the best Beauty and Brawn in a very long time because we had guests this week.
So many guests. Guests on guests on guests.
A lot of guests. Starts out at a breakfast with Rob Bailey and, of course, Austin, his sidekick. A lot of their followers will know who Austin is, of course. But Rob Bailey was in town for a little hangout action, wanted to get some Florida sun.
You actually cooked a sea bass for him, too.
Later in the week. You just blew up that part of the story.
Traveling. I like the...
Hey, guys.
Hi, how are you?
Hey,
how are you?
It's been a while.
I know. It's been a while.
Yeah. Do you guys want...
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
All of you?
Yeah.
Please.
That's good. Oh, that one before.
Get that.
I left the top down. I hope it stays not raining.
Oh, I thought you left it overnight. That was a hurricane in the middle of the night.
The top of mine, when I closed it, and all the rainwater came into the car. I didn't know.
Yeah, correct.
Yeah.
Weird life.
It's a struggle.
I took the VO6 today, so it's not automatic. You have to actually take the carbon fiber off. No, thank you. Just water.
Blackstone is a really great example of that as well.
Yeah.
You know? Doing really well.
Direct to consumers. That's what people want. You know what I mean? I mean, even with our music, people actually comment, they're like, so where should I buy it from so you get the most money?
Yeah.
Because I want to support you, I don't want to support iTunes, I don't want to support, like, if they have a connection with the brand.
Yeah.
What do you tell them when you get for his, the Mavericks, too.
Mm-hmm. That's
they
great.
Use it for the both Texas teams. They both stole it too. Neither of them paid us for it. Yeah.
That's great. He's done some hilarious shit over the years.
He doesn't care.
I remember when he ran his mouth about the fast food, how much they get paid or whatever. This is going back probably to like when I was in college. And he got a lot of flack for it. So he went and worked an entire day at like a McDonald's.
Oh yeah, he said said something about, a Wendy's worker,
mm-hmm.
even a Wendy's manager could do it.
Yeah, so then he went and did it, and then he went and came out and, said how hard it was and everything, but, they had him working in the window and stuff. Pretty funny.
They see him fatter babies, but they've never seen a taller and bigger baby.
Really? Now what?
He's destined to be a pro bodybuilder.
No. Be a big businessman.
Maybe he'll be a football player.
That would be cool. I'd be that.
Howard,
the whole room.
Do I like reptiles? I don't understand them enough. They make me nervous. I don't know what they're thinking. If you can teach me what they're about to do, like, is he about to bite you?
None of them will bite you.
Okay.
For that.
Yeah.
When I would feed them, when I'm at your house, I like stick my hand and like put the lettuce in.
None of them will.
Rob Bailey.
Oh, Young Marino?
Young Marino.
Reno.
Yeah, he's from Mario.
Really cool. Watching him eat is awesome. We'll feed him in front of you.
Oh, yeah.
He shoots his tongue out to catch the crickets. By their actual names or what they are?
But I gotta start
with names. No, because they're named after mostly Breaking Bad characters, but you wanna know what they actually are or what just their names?
I like the name.
Young Marino, Venus, Serena, Russell, Vito, Mr. Chow. Mr. Chow's a Chinese water dragon. Salamanca, Gustavo Frang, Skinny Pete, Alejandro, Selena, Pablito, and then I have Tommy, and Lazarus.
Ooh, intense name.
Lazarus is a blue-eyed Lucidic, so he's without color, so it's a different form of albino. Usually albinos are yellow. He's pure white and has blue eyes, so they call him blue-eyed Lucis.
He's driving like 30 minutes for everything, no matter what.
No, one of the best parts of Boca is there's no 30 minutes nothing.
Yes, Northeast is. Like when I was in Connecticut, going to like
his was the worst.
Oh, everything was a 20-minute drive.
Yeah, everything was 20 minutes.
That's why for me, like down here, where people are like, oh, it's so far. I'm like, it's 10 minutes. What are you talking about?
Oh, and you're like, dude, I live like a solid 20 minutes that way. I was like, oh, okay.
I used to drive 3 or 4 times a week, an hour to the gym.
How about when you lived?
So I could train in.
How about when you lived in California?
Oh, I had to.
Actually, 90 minutes each way.
There was actually no gym in my town,
except for the little tiny
gym I ever lived. And I finally found this fucking place that was like worse than a hotel gym.
Yeah.
That I would do for like shoulders and arms, just when I didn't want to drive.
And all it was all gay people.
It would be PJ and I, like a little tiny gay
dude. Yeah. King of the game.
He loved it though.
He was like king of the
game. I batted a very high average in that gym. So that's how Tuesday started, and then we went to the office. We had to have some meetings about things going on for the Arnold and some other business things. And I'm not going to really talk about it. I want you guys to just see the way that all flows out there.
If we had to bring one black crown
for the Arnold, or remember, we're trying to go much less.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a great height.
The only one I'm actually doing the fuck cut of is Dust.
Yeah, I was going to say. Yeah.
Me and you have been talking about performing Dust forever, right? Mm-hmm. But like, instead of 120 hype, 60 each hype. And even that's a lot.
Yeah.
But that's because we can sell stacks that all day with Dust and hype. We can upsell that in the booth like crazy. We'll tell people it's $30 for Dust or $55 for both Dust and hype, and people buy both. 36 Formal 19 Black Piranha. We're not going to bring that to flavors.
We're only bringing 6 isolations.
Each flavor.
It was only 2 flavors. It's 12. Yep. So I mean, is that just for the display?
You can fit 6 total in the display. We can bring more.
If it's just for display to like leave it there and not sell it?
We can sell a couple of the units, but I would like to not.
Yeah.
It's really hard to ship.
Yeah, I would say that it's like kind of almost pointless to have it then. Because people are going to ask for it, and we're going to break the display to sell it to them, or just not have it there.
That's something we got to choose. If you look at the booth, like this is our storage area.
I would not bring it because people aren't going to be buying protein. They just want deals on the, you know.
So I can just bring ice, I can just bring 3 total isolation, have one little row or something. We'll just bring. We can do that too.
Yeah.
We're going to put shirts on this back wall here.
Mm-hmm.
And we're hanging, you know how like the Boca Nutrition and the Celestial Body stuff hangs? We're going to apply that, instead of putting shirts in here and like having it sort of shitty, I'll actually hang them up all along this back wall.
Cool.
That way we open up these 2 cases, so we can have mostly this just like Dust in one of the cases, to be honest. Dust and a couple other flagship products. And like the side products like the support and the other lesser like resurgence and Nesotize, things like that, the side case.
So,
yeah, what does Celeste listen to?
She really listens to like...
I figured she listens to like, honestly, like, I thought she was listening to Pop or Country.
She listens to a lot of like 90s, like 90s hits, like on like satellite, like the 90s hits.
That's fair.
And she listens to more like hip-hop-y type stuff. Like if I look at what she's listening to when she's working out, like Eminem, or like she listens to like a lot of like dubstep, like Skrillex type stuff, but not on a level where like she's not into like Tiesto and like all those like club guys, David Guetta and all that. It's more just like the stuff that doesn't actually have lyrics and just like intense beats.
Gotcha.
Very interesting.
I'm still surprised that Aaron Singer even listens to music. You know what I mean? Like,
to me, it's always surprising when he is like passionate about
certain things, and it's like something you'd never ever think of. Like that band that's like a, they're like a shitty Nirvana. Something Milk or something they're called, like.
Neutral Milk?
Yeah.
He likes Neutral Milk?
He loves them. He went to go see them in concert, and I was like, I never heard of them. And he was like, really? He's like, dude, they're just like Nirvana. And I listened to it, I was like, a really shitty Nirvana, maybe. I mean, they're definitely not just like Nirvana. Or like,
he told me he never listened to music before, I believe.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Or like when he said that he was really into Primus. Like, really? I've never met anyone that was really into Primus. Like, I've never even seen anybody in like a Primus shirt before, unless it was to like get a laugh. And most people only know Primus because of South Park. And I bet you he probably doesn't know that they do the theme song for South Park, which is funny. Yeah, he, I know he was listening to like Rob Bailey stuff and stuff like that. And that's it. We're going to take it right into Wednesday. Wednesday, this was the big day because...
It was a big day. It was very stressful that day.
It was a stressful day, but it was all leading up to the dinner that night. But we're going to go all the way back to the beginning of the day. I was excited, and I wasn't going to let anything ruin my day because we were going to have the radio show. Rob Bailey, really the reason he was here was to hang out and come on and do the radio show with us and stuff. And I was all excited about it. And it was like everything that could go wrong leading up to that went wrong.
Literally.
Including we had a little fight with people in the office. Salvina, who you guys all know and love, got into it with Howard.
I pumped it out, but I've never screamed so loud.
What was it about?
About the employees. Nobody would have done the job that we did to get 4,000 samples packed.
Yeah.
For $10 to $12 an hour.
Mm-hmm.
Aaron started texting him and he's like, 25 is too much, 15. And even that, next time, let's outsource it so like I don't get involved. Like I was technically the supervisor. My people get paid 25 an hour. Like, I wouldn't have done it.
You could have had Liv doing that. She gets only paid $10 an hour.
Yeah, but like I most certainly wouldn't have spent every night in that warehouse.
No, I wouldn't have wanted you to do that.
And it's almost like, he calls me then a socialist because I, like, just because they don't have money, like, we have to pay them the higher rate. No, because we broke our asses every night is why we should get the higher rate. So, one, we had the discussion here, and he said, like, I wasn't there for that. I'm like, what did you want me to do? Like, shake you in your chair? And two, my email says I respectfully ask. I'm not the final say around here, and if that's what Aaron Singerman wants, absolutely. But going forward, any project that I'm attached to, I want to know the rate.
How many days did you work on that?
Clay did 6, I did 4. It came to a total of $900. If you would have outsourced it, you would have paid $3,000.
Okay.
And like, I'm just tired of it, and I think I exploded because I've been dealing with that for a year. And like, here I am attaching myself to a project, being like, hey guys, I'm going to fight for us to get paid. I'm going to fight for us to get paid. And I'm watching. Like, we all had better things to do, and we all would have not done it for $10 to $12.
Mm-hmm.
But if Aaron Singerman says 15, okay, but like it's one more thing that like I'm doing that
I don't want you doing stuff like that.
Yeah, but that's what it is to be a team player. That's
no, but I didn't. I saw the images, and that was how I found out about it. I saw a Snapchat or wherever I saw that you did,
because you
and
know
that
what?
Was the first I even heard of it.
It's important to like always remember, like to help out. You don't,
of course. You just, I mean, if it was a true team, though, like I would know things that are going on, so.
No one was out of line. Me and Howard are gonna have respectful disagreements. I had to walk away, and we literally hugged it out.
How many hours do you think that you spent doing that extra?
I spent 12, Clay did 18, one kid did 2, another kid did 6.
So it's a pretty big project. Yeah. Okay. I'll make sure that this gets worked out.
Hugged it out in the end, which is good. I had to have a meeting with Derek about the direction and future of Boca Nutrition. I'll see a little bit of Derek, who is the guy that's running my 2 stores and soon to be 3rd store.
Probably 4.
So he's on a boat or something, I guess.
Yeah.
Nice.
Doing fun stuff.
Yeah.
All right, so I just want to stay in communication, basically, mm-hmm. Make sure everybody's on the same page. We have some ideas, because obviously we want to make sure that Boca Nutrition becomes not a priority like Blackstone Labs, but like it's in the mix.
Yeah.
You know, I know we do a lot of films, videos, pictures, stuff like that. I just want to see how involved we can get and see what kind of difference it can make, because obviously Blackstone is built on a lot of social media and a lot of outreach. Mm-hmm. So a couple ideas that my team came up with, a commercial during the Beauty and Brawn for Boca Nutrition.
That's a good idea.
Because I know they're long segments, so a little break in between of like maybe 2 or 3 minutes of the shops, one of each or both with the staff.
2 or 3 minutes might be long, but 30 seconds,
well,
I think.
Yeah, well, that's, yeah, exactly. Something like that.
Yeah, we can definitely do that. I mean, I can, I guess we'll have Eric just like get some footage of the shops, and I guess we'll kind of like write a storyline for how we want the commercial to be.
Yeah, and we can update them every so often.
Yeah, no, we can definitely get that.
And with the personalities I think we have between Sam and Danny alone, they can be entertaining.
Who is running the Facebook page?
With the major one?
Yeah.
Because there's two. I have the East one just for a check-in ability, yep, so that people can know it's there.
Yeah, I know Gizmo does the Instagram.
And he copies everything over to Facebook.
Okay, so I'll have a talk with him about getting behind proper Facebook marketing, because the Facebook can change the game for that stuff, like,
absolutely,
really fast.
Yeah.
Because you can't, Instagram, you can't target Boca.
Yeah.
On Facebook, I can target ads to the whole area of Boca, so.
And I'm thinking we need something that's like, Gizmo brought up something to me about like Boca butts or something.
Mm-hmm.
Like drawing that kind of a crowd to the shops, because like, it's catchy.
Yeah.
I think some of our content's a little dry sometimes, and
yeah,
the page gets overlooked because it's like, oh, Blackstone's really awesome. Boca's kind of like, it's just, the FAU ones can be for Boca Nutrition East specifically if we want it. But I do need some general ones that I can use for both locations, for gyms, chiropractors, doctors in the area, anywhere that I can, you know, set up a table and promote Boca Nutrition. I need something else.
Okay.
Hand somebody for them to want to come in, say a Boca 10 discount, or you get an extra 5% off. You get 15% because you're part of this.
Is Boca doing anything at a Karina show on Saturday?
I know Blackstone Prime, Celestial Bodies, and City Blends are all there, which we basically are all of those things.
Yeah.
So there's not like, we're not a title on her list of sponsors. Because again, there's a lot of shows that I'd like to be part of, but I don't know, I should just reach out to you, I guess, months in advance to make sure that we have spots available, because I know they cost money.
Yeah.
We do have a tablecloth, we do have everything that we would need to set up. I don't know how Karina handles that if we're like, hey, we want to be there because all of our other companies are there.
Oh yeah, text her.
Because Sergio's willing to already go. Sergio's already asked me, like, hey, I like doing these demos. He did a CrossFit one, I guess, the week prior and loved it. So he's asking for any more opportunities he can have to do more.
And a few other things went wrong, but eventually we got to do the radio show, which you guys will see a little bit of.
Ready, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Welcome back to another episode of Iron Empire Radio with me and PJ. We took a week off, but we're back because, I think mostly because, we have a very special guest in the house right now, Robert Rob Bailey.
I like that you called me special.
Special, yes.
I feel good.
He
right
is
now.
So special that I said today, because I have a lot going on, and there is, we have athletes in town, and there's a shoot that's going on tomorrow, plus I'm cooking dinner for some people tonight.
Ooh,
and I said that the only reason that I was still here is because it's Rob Bailey.
Yep. Wow. All the specialness.
It's a lot of pressure on you, right?
Yeah. 78 degree office that we're sitting
in. If this show is not good at all, PJ later will be like, I wasted my time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's the truth. Today we had an interesting day. Actually, this has been an action-packed trip. Rob and Austin. Austin's in the corner over there. Austin, yell something so people can hear you.
Hi.
There he is. Ooh, there he is. There's Austin in the back. They've been here for a few days now. What, they got here 2 days ago?
Right? Yeah.
And it's been action-packed since you got here, right?
Yeah, tons of action.
Sometimes you need a little action. In life.
Yeah, I like it. Yeah. I like Florida action. It's 7 degrees in Pennsylvania right now.
Yeah,
so, 7? Yeah, oof, around there. Oof. Dana's 7. Actually stuck on top of our mountain because she can't get the tractor started to plow.
Oh my god.
Meanwhile, I'm on a fucking boat.
Yeah, he's sending my pictures shirt on the boat. Yeah.
Just rubbing it in.
Yeah.
Maybe you can like rig like a shovel to like the goat's back and they can like dig her out somehow. They're not work goats.
The full video is actually up on YouTube, ready, if you want to check it out, Iron Empire Radio. And then that night, We actually had everybody over for dinner.
It was party time.
But it wasn't just Rob Bailey that we had over for dinner.
We flew in our two newest Heavenly Bodiez, Miss Carriejune, the most precious little thing of all time. Mm-hmm.
All 4'10 of her.
Gorgeous, fabulous Caroline DeCampos. And they came, and so we had three very special guests in our house. And Jack, of course, every time anyone comes over, it's always the best day of Jack's life. And then this one here cooked like 10, was it 10?
10 sea bass, yes.
10 absolutely perfect sea bass. He cooks a very good sea bass, and he makes it for me a lot, but he nailed like every single one of them. People were like stuffing themselves. He actually ate more than he should have sea bass wise, and it really, sea bass isn't good for his stomach.
Sea bass has a little, it's like a microscopic organism that is in the parasite family, and it's not a scary one that like does anything bad to you, but some people have a weird allergy to it, and I am one of those people, and it makes me poop a lot.
Get in a pouch like this, and then steam it on the grill. It's awesome. I think cod smells weird. There's just like something about the smell of it that I don't like. Same thing with flounder. Very big piece of salmon. 3 pounds. Want me to come help you with that real quick so we can help do stuff that like matters more?
This doesn't matter, I said in the middle of the thing that piece is The only other place that has better Brussels sprouts than when I cook them is Prime 112. They have amazing Brussels sprouts. Enough so that people who don't eat them would eat them. All right, you behave. Hey, you behave. Let me pick her up. Come here. Oh, okay. She's gonna be a nightmare. Hi! Hold on, let me make the bee sit.
Hi!
It's okay, sit down. Oh,
he's
a cat. He's an American bully. I'm gonna put him up really quick. Come here. Come on.
I have a step too.
Go in your room.
Hi!
Hi.
Good to meet you finally.
Good to meet you too.
Hi, nice to see you, Ann.
Very nice to see you.
Welcome to my home.
So once like we get going and stuff, it'll be a lot better.
Yeah.
But I shot at that studio Monday and it's really cool. They have like graffiti, like a whole graffiti wall in the back.
Oh, I saw that.
It's all done by like different artists and stuff. And then there's on the inside, like tons of different like backgrounds, like the brick, and like there's a matte black wall, and then of course there's a white backdrop. The whole place is just really cool.
So, did you tell them what time they're starting tomorrow?
Yeah, I didn't get there yet, but so I will probably arrive before 9, set everything up, and then the makeup artist, she's gonna get there at 9, do me, so I'll be done, and then you guys will get there by 9:45 at the latest. Then like whoever wants to go first, it doesn't really matter. And then I'll be done so I can like kind of whoever finishes first. The main priority in the beginning is to just like get some individual stuff for Celeste Bodiez. Like,
okay.
So we can use it for graphics, for sales and stuff. Like,
right.
We like to make each girl an individual graphic to post for like a specific sale so they can still use your code. So that is like important. And then once we're all done, hair and makeup, we'll do a lot of group stuff. And then it'll be fun. Like, we don't have to necessarily do white background. It can be in, like, there's a roof that we can go on. So, like, I want to do a lot of group stuff. And then as soon as we get as much as we need for Celeste Bodiez, so that's the priority, then you guys can do, like, the individual looks. I know which Justin's very excited about.
Oh, my God.
You should be unsalted. No.
lost, he's losing his voice. I don't know.
But on top of, he was feeling really, really sick last night. And I was like, dude, just take some NyQuil and go to sleep so you can be better for tomorrow.
Right.
And this morning he was like, feeling a lot better and went on a boat all day.
He was feeling better earlier. But that's what
because they showed up at the office all tired and out of it. And I was waiting all that time for him. And he was like, oh, I'm so tired. And I was like, if you're going to not do the show now, I'm going to be very, very angry because I've been waiting here for you guys the whole time.
She is a little. She won't bite you. Look at her face. She's like, she won't bite you. She won't bark at you for a long time. Are you being? He's bringing you his little.
If you hadn't pointed out your motor on out there,
oh, it's a little moat.
I would have stepped in it. I like
it. Oh my
it.
God. So listen, when we bought this house like 6 months ago,
so I'll be right back.
The pump didn't work, and so we've had like estimate after estimate to like try to figure out what to do. They want to like dig up our whole driveway and put new piping and stuff. Did you look how gross it is?
Of course, dig up the whole driveway.
Yeah, but we just did our driveway, so we were like, oh, let's try to avoid that. But in the meantime, like, I'm trying to get someone to do my landscaping and the moat at once, so it's like.
I'll get you the moat.
We want to extend it around the front yard. Yeah, like check Dari's page for like the gross
food. You are mid hair.
My cooking situation. Yeah, I did the best I could. I wasn't like overly proud, but this time I am, actually. So I'm pretty happy about it. Alright, who?
Middle age.
I know there are people that actually do like steak or want steak, so I mean two different like small skirt steaks. But there's 3 pounds of salmon and there's like there's a piece of sea bass for everybody too. So I ate one of them. I'll just start plating stuff and either you eat it or you don't, I guess. We'll leave it at that. They won't need a knife for any of the fish. The people that are eating steak.
Okay, I'm grabbing all that we have for you.
Ooh, Jackson?
Jackson? Okay, knives and forks are right here. Get a knife.
Nice curry.
Asparagus is good.
See? Don't like it. I didn't put
it. I've actually never tried
part,
but I did.
You
get a very
good
one. Right here. Go ahead. Oh, right here. I'm sure
that's to do a shoe, and I was like, it was the most awkward thing that I have like ever seen.
Alright. It's chocolate, it's protein, and chocolate and banana, right?
It's all three of them mixed in?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's good.
Does it make the best shakes in town?
It was leading into Thursday. It was for a very big event on Thursday.
It was, it was very stressful because, first of all, I was very excited because we haven't done a really big group photo shoot in a long time, and usually it's at our house, and I picked a studio, and I was like, just losing my mind because I'm in the shoot also because I have to get images of myself. Because I think it's important to like be a part of the shoots, but I also direct everything too. So like making sure like everything is coordinating, everyone's getting done, like all the girls are putting the right outfit on, doing the right poses, like who's doing what. So it's like the most stressful thing, but it was such an amazing shoot.
It's a lot of work to get a bunch of people shot in a day. We usually do in our house. We did it in the studio. The studio was cool, but it was very hot.
It was too hot. Like, I will never shoot in a place like that again because it was so hot. I had to get my makeup done like 3 times, and it was like just adding on to my stress level. But like every single one of the girls took amazing pictures, and like, you know, we're redoing our site soon, so all of those pictures I wanted to be part of like our new cool concept, and so everything just like came together perfectly.
They used the, there's like this photography team, LXG, it's like 4 letters, I can never remember the letters.
Uh-huh.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. You know, we like always call them the element of these, because we can never remember the letters.
So alpha.
Dominate.
I am.
I like wrestling school's not too far from here. We should go wrestle after this.
We should. I'll be like full hair makeup, so
yeah.
You want to be a wrestler?
Huh?
Yeah.
You wrestled a little bit.
Yeah, down here, they have a school down here, so I did it for like a year and a half.
Oh,
fun,
really?
Just for fun, yeah.
Cool.
So I can sell a clothesline.
Yeah, he sells.
So fuck,
sells
my
stuff pretty
you,
good.
Yeah, you don't sell anything.
I've been no selling.
You've been no selling me. You've been undertakering me so hard.
What would your wrestling name be?
It would be Eric, the cameraman. Nice.
Eric. Eric the salesman.
You could go with a stereotype on YouTube. You get a luchador mask and.
No, my name would now be Fagbardo, because that's what I'm on YouTube. That's what all the trolls call me, is the hate song.
Really? What the fuck? That's horrible.
That's bad.
They say deport him, fire the Mexican.
He's an illegal alien.
It's terrible. It's the most terrible thing.
That, you know, Instagram and Twitter can be a vehicle for a lot of negativity.
Mm-hmm.
For sure.
Wait, you can get my finger.
Sorry, what happened?
No, I strained my finger a week ago.
Hi, Amanda.
Hi.
Little Carriejune over there.
So awkward.
This is Jan.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I've heard great things.
Oh, thank you.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Oh, you're so cute.
Thank you.
You're cute too.
Oh, thanks.
You wipe that down.
Okay.
Whatever you say.
1961 is the password. Gotcha. Capital Z. Mm.
If you just want to, if you just want to hold it too, because it's got the long front and long back, you know, like.
Right. Right. Yeah.
Whatever. That's go with it. You know, great. What feels comfortable on your body.
Okay.
we should just start shooting stuff.
And then we'll be done. You have a, it's a new tattoo.
Oh, yeah.
That's what I just said. And we just said that.
Yeah. I thought it was like something that is
right.
Good for the
pictures. Right, right, right. Yeah.
Put your necklace in the inside.
Oh, it is so hot out here. I do not like it.
Let me see, just put your right hand on the man's leg, a little lower, right there. So let's back up right again, sir. There you go. All right, girls, ready? One, two, three.
It was very hot, and I don't want to keep saying that, and I don't want to talk bad about the people that had this shoot, but it killed my day. I was shooting Carriejune also for some Blackstone Lab stuff, and it was just too hot to really even focus. The shoot didn't even end until after 6 o'clock. Took the girls to the gym after that.
Yeah, we all trained after that.
Yeah, we all trained still, and then went to Santos, which was nice.
I wanted to mention that Amanda Otero was part of the shoot. We didn't mention her at first because she didn't fly in. She's local. She works for us, but she was part of the shoot, and we got some like really hot photos of her too. So that was exciting.
Good stuff. Cotton candy dust. that takes us to Friday, which is the last day of the video. We had a very important meeting. We're at a position now at our lives in business with Blackstone Lives and the other companies that we have different investment bankers, investors, other people that want to do business with us at different times. It's a lot like Shark Tank in my office, and sometimes we're the sharks and sometimes we're on the other side. A lot of times we're the sharks, which is interesting, and we've been in position to unfortunately crush some people's dreams and then help some people with their dreams. But it's very, very exciting and stressful, but worth every minute of it. You'll see a little bit of that. We don't want to get too into the meetings that we had on Friday.
I hurt my knee. I have no clue how. I went to bed fine, and I'm like limping today.
So there he is. What up, Pete?
I woke up with a bum leg today somehow.
Bum leg?
Yeah. I'm going to see if I can get the girl to come work on me when you guys leave.
No.
I'm just going to like barely put you in.
How you doing, man? Great to meet you. Hey, thanks very much for taking the time.
See this right here? Well, how much bulked out it is compared to the other side?
What, you just woke up that way?
Yeah, I stepped out of bed and my whole leg buckled. And then Celeste was like, oh my God, look at where... I don't know if I popped one of the tendons or something somehow.
Oh, it hurts like that?
Yeah, I'm gonna have... I called Deanna to see if she can come here in a little while to help me out.
Yeah, yeah. When I spoke to you on the phone, you didn't mention this.
It was like...
You did cardio like that?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Did cardio too? That couldn't have helped.
Because I felt like I did it really slow and flat to try to see if I could get blood in the area and stimulate it to loosen it up, because I couldn't bend it all the way, and I wanted to see if that would help. Sometimes when you bring blood flow to the area, yeah, you can actually stimulate it to loosen everything up again. But probably Excuse me?
Do you have a history of
back?
No, I have never had any issues with my lower body, like...
Yeah, sometimes I can't pay the meniscus and create some fluid in that area,
yeah,
and pop out like that.
Well, this over here would be... meniscus would be inside more.
No, but I mean, if I've had meniscal irritation, uh-huh, I don't have a tear, but it'll wind up, you know, the effusion will push out.
Push it out, maybe that will
get a little fluid there. I just, you know, got it aspirated.
I'm also wondering if it's something I did because this is your posterior tibialis right here. This is your anterior tibialis, and they go like, this is what they do. And I perhaps was just doing some sort of like incline walking and strained the muscle, because the muscle is very, very sore. If that's the case, it's pulling on it, simple fix, so.
So before we get in with him, I got two questions for you, okay, as it relates to working out in your badass workout videos, which I absolutely love, by the way.
The Muscle and Fitness ones?
I think it's
fun. I got an email blast. First one.
So, but let me, I have a real question, and I assume you've probably gotten a lot of these, and I knew I would meet you.
Okay.
I can't do anymore.
Why?
Because you can't do supersets like that in a gym that's crowded.
It's hard to do it in a gym.
So I can't do any of them the way you do them. I can only do individual workout. So I was going to ask you,
yeah,
if you've been getting this question, my recommendation for someone like me would be
3 a.m.
What's the adjustment?
I do that stuff when I can, which is not all the time. So when Muscle Fitness asked me to do a series for them, I didn't want to do like the average guy's workout of the week, because what's going to be exciting about that? I want to do something that people would be like, oh my God, this is next to impossible
to
do.
How do you, because I, first of all, some of the, I've been doing some of the exercises individually, and I love them,
yeah,
right? Some of them I haven't seen before, and just the way you explain it is awesome.
Good.
But if I was saying is, I don't know who can do most of those, because mm-hmm, most gyms are crowded.
Yeah.
And when you don't have a camera and someone's saying, don't go on this, there's no way of bouncing back and forth, so it becomes, for me, it's impossible to do.
A couple things that I've done. Number one, I've made my workouts in order on days where typically the rest of the world is not training those body parts, which is not, that's going to be a little bit tricky from gym to gym.
But don't do chest on Monday.
Every gym that I go to, when I do legs on Monday, no one's doing legs.
Right.
And then when I'm doing chest on Tuesday,
right,
it's usually, the only one that I've run into some issues with is I find it's very common that people are doing arms on Saturday, because it's like they want to pump up before they go out to the bar or whatever they're going to do, you know?
Makes sense.
So that's one thing. Another thing that you can do is you can structure it around looking at what you think might be available and then pair those things, because it's not necessarily about those. I mean, doing those exact exercises, of course, is the ideal way to do it.
Right.
But if you can do similar exercises or things that, you know, maybe if you grabbed a bench and moved it out of the way, you could superset or even giant set an incline press with a flat fly.
People seem to get annoyed when you say the machine is open.
They do,
and
but
say, hey, I'm doing supersets.
They absolutely do.
In a crowded gym, and
they absolutely do. But what I have also decided is another thing. Once I was in California, this is when I made this shift. Is I realized that I don't care about any of those people. So if they don't like me, I'm not there to make friends. I'm actually not wanting to be friends with any of them, so I can get them out.
No, I know, but you see, you run
into people. So like, I used to be real polite about it, be like, excuse me, like I'm gonna be using these two and I'll be fast and this and that. Yeah. Sometimes people get pissed. By the time I was at like the end, because people in California are the worst. You can tell them that, and you turn around, they're taking your thing off and moving.
Yeah, I noticed people do that now.
So by the time I was at my end, I would literally be like, hey, don't use that, I'm using it. And because I'm a bigger guy, you know, a lot of times they'd be like, okay. And sometimes even if you're not a big guy, they'll just stay out of your way.
I adjust the workout where it just, you're not done in 45 minutes, you've done it
the
hour
best 15 way to do it, honestly, the best way to do it
still could do that, right?
Is this is the easiest fix, is because my whole philosophy is on the time under tension, is to stay on that exercise and do numerous drop sets.
So instead of the super drop set individual.
So like, let's say you're doing a lat pull down, you do 10 as hard as you can, cut the weight. Do 10 more, cut the weight.
Cut the weight.
And then the muscle's under tension for a very long period of time. So like when you do most of my giant sets, if you time them, it's about 90 seconds. Oh. And the studies show that 90 seconds under tension, your body starts to really pulse growth hormone out, which is why I believe I stay so lean too. Of course, I eat clean and do everything else, but when I started doing that at the end of my bodybuilding career, people would be like, oh, are you dieting really hard for a show? And I was, no, it's just it's the way that I'm training. My body has changed like this. And now that I've been retired for 3 years, I actually thought that I'd be much, much, much smaller than I am now. And I am smaller, but I believe that it's all because of the way that I train. So I started wanting to implement that into everybody else.
So drop set them instead of super setting with the other ones, and then just go to each machine as the gym allows. You think this is your time?